The year was 1949, and Harry S. Truman was the President of the United States as one of the most violent decades in world history came to an end. As world leaders met to discuss the matter of peace and post-war recovery, a group of 9 Central Kentucky church leaders were holding their own meetings to discuss a dream and a vision. Their dream? A Christian service camp where the young people of Central Kentucky could come together, leave behind their daily distraction, deepen their relationship with Christ, and train for full-time Christian service. By the end of the decade, the dream was becoming a reality, and though they did not have a permanent name nor home, camp was being held for the youth of Central Kentucky at YMCA Camp Daniel Boone under the name Bluegrass Christian Service Camp. In 1949, the dream finally would receive a permanent home. In the summer of 1949, those 9 visionary church leaders incorporated under the name Bluegrass Christian Assembly and purchased 10 acres of land known as Old Gentry's Mill on the Fayette-Clark County line. The old mill had been a landmark of the bluegrass for over a century, serving as water wheel grist mill before it was purchased by local business interest that turned the old mill into a roadhouse dance hall. Within a year, the dance business had proved to be less than profitable, and the owners decided to sell the property. After receiving no serious bids at public auction, the old mill was noticed by local real estate agent, a member of one of the local churches, who, thinking it would make a great home for a camp, pitched the idea to leaders of the Bluegrass Christian Service Camp. The men quickly moved to purchase the property, incorporating under the name Bluegrass Christian Assembly on June 30, 1949, and signing a contract for purchase of the property less than a month later on July 29th. In order to guarantee the purchase price of $40,000, several of the incorporators signed personal notes and made other financial sacrifices. And by late summer in 1949, Bluegrass Christian Assembly was open for camp. Over 50 years have passed since that summer in 1949, when 9 men, combining vision, faith, and prayer, laid the foundation for what we know today as Bluegrass Christian Camp. The name has changed slightly, and though the old mill still remains, the appearance of the camp has changed as well. Bluegrass Christian Camp has grown from the original 10 acres with 4 buildings purchased for $40,000 to 40 acres with 14 buildings, a swimming pool, and assets totaling nearly $3 million. To date, nearly 50,000 campers have attended camp sessions, many becoming ministers, elders, deacons, Sunday school teachers, missionaries, and more. What would the church look like today if there had not been a Bluegrass Christian Camp?